course, was Dreams, Fleetwood Mac's enormous hit a few years ago. It was written and sung by Stevie Nicks, who is joining us this morning. Actually, we're joining her in her hotel room here in New York. Good morning.
Good morning.
This is your first solo album. How does Fleetwood Mac feel about what you're doing?
Well, I don't really know exactly how they feel. I guess they're glad. You know, when we're together, it's just like nothing happened. You know, I was with them all last week, recording for 5 days, and 5 days straight, all day and most of the night. And we don't talk about it much. It's kind of, you know.
You're off doing your thing.
We just don't spend a lot of time talking about it. And, you know, as far as they're concerned, I'm still a part of Fleetwood Mac. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm still a part of Fleetwood Mac. So there's no, you know, I'm not going to walk around bragging about what I'm doing, so I never mention it.
Yeah.
And that's the best.
But what happens when they go back on the road and you're not always there?
Well, I'd have to go. They can't go on the road without me. So if they go again, I'll have to go.
What about
I don't mind going as long as it's not for you.
It seems like the rock industry is really a male dominated world. Is it tough in that world to be a woman?
It is a very male oriented world.
Is it that way?
Yes, it is. And anybody who says it isn't crazy, because it is. And you do have to fight for every little step of the way. I've been fighting for 6 years to get noticed as a songwriter. I never really cared about being noticed as a performer or a singer. I wanted to, you know, get some soul gratification from writing songs. And, like, you know, like, that's difficult. It's difficult for them to say, you did well. So they want to, I think, but it's really hard for them to actually, especially the real heavy male songwriters, it's really hard for them to say, well, you wrote a good song, you know. They would rather not. They do, after a point, they'll kind of, you know, they're kind of smiling and giving me a little pat on the shoulder. And I know that's really about as much as I can expect from them.
Mm.
And that's all right, because at least I am successful doing my writing.
Do you enjoy doing what you do?
Yeah. I enjoy parts of it.
It's just like any
other job when it comes to, there are parts of it, if you have a job that you love, and there are parts of it that you don't love. You know, I don't love the traveling. I don't love the eating different food in different towns, which makes the system go haywire every day. The time is constantly changing. So, you're always disoriented. I don't like waking up and not knowing where I am. It's a little scary sometimes to wonder if you can ever live a normal life again. And that's the part I don't like. And that's the part that I won't do anymore. I won't go out in 3 or 4 years. And so when I come home, I don't feel any more at home at my home than I do at a hotel. And that, for me, that's the scary part. I think that's what show business people will say, you know, it's hard to be normal. It is hard to be normal when you're just as comfortable on the 50th floor of a hotel as you are in your own home.
And why do they do it? I mean, we see, you know, these rock groups, and they do it forever. They do it until they're 50.
They're obsessed. They just love, you know. I mean, for me, Nick and John love to be on the road. They love to be on the road. They would rather be on the road than anywhere else, you know, than to go to the house every day, you know, room service. There are things that some people truly love about it and would really rather never go home. I personally like, you know, making a burrito and putting it in the microwave. You can't do that on the road.
Yeah.
In fact, you can't do anything on the road. So it doesn't make so much of a lot.
What do you want out of life, Susie?
I want to be able to do all the different things that I love to do in the part of it that I love. I want to be able to go on the road and tour for 6 weeks, whether it be with Matt or with myself. Yeah. And I want to be able to have enough time to rest so that I have revived and come back to life, so that the next time I walk on stage, I look happy and I look like I'm having fun, because it is so much fun. That's, you know, the 2.5 hours on stage every night are the only thing that make it worth it. And for the people that go and don't get to go on stage, it's all the 50 people that work behind you. I don't know how they do it. I don't know how they stand it. Because they don't get that little bit of glory No, they don't get to come home and write. If I could take all of you up with me on that stage for one moment, then it would be worth it to you. I can't take them with me. And so I don't understand why they even go. So I love all the people that go with us, you know, and help us and keep us going.
Do you have any desires to act?
No.
None?
Not really. I never, even when I was really little, it never occurred to me to be a movie star. Because I knew that movie stars had to get up at 5 o'clock and wait for the light. And I don't like the light, so I like the dark. So this goes totally against every little fiber in my body to get up early and wait for a certain light. So I would rather sing and write music and write books and children's stories and anything else. I'm too old to be a movie star. I'm too old to start over and do that.
Well, a special thank you, then, for getting up in the daylight for us.
Thank you.
And good luck on the new album. We do, by the way, have some videotapes of you singing with Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers, one of the songs from your new album, Stop Dragging My Heart Around.
Which, I must tell you, is probably the most romantic and wonderful thing I've ever done, to walk on stage with Tom and be an honorary heartbreaker for a moment. It's just the neatest thing that has ever happened to me.